I don't know when we got cut off there. I didn't even notice. So here we are in First Kings 14 verse 23. And they also built them high places and images and groves on every high hill and under every green tree. This word groves is Asherah. And there were also Sodomites in the land, and they did according to all the abominations of the nations which Yahweh cast out before the children of Israel. Sodomites, groves, these are Asherah, giant tree worship, referred to in Exodus 34, the Sodomites. The Sodomites were explicitly committers of the sin of Sodom. Genesis 19, they were male prostitutes dedicated to idolatry involving this sin connected with Asherah. They worshipped trees. The way they worshipped them was doing this sexual act. They were ass whores. Doing this worshipping act towards the trees. Sodomites were Asherah worshippers, tree huggers. It's pretty ironic. So they were the first idol worshippers. Okay, we're done with that one. Let's go to 1 Kings 15. First Kings 15:11, and Asa did that which was right in the eyes of Yahweh, as did his father. And he took away the Sodomites out of the land, removed all the idols that his father had made. This word idols is filthy idols. And Makkah, his mother, even her he removed from being queen. His own mother, because she had made an idol in a grove, and Asa destroyed her idol and burnt it by the brook Kidron. So this idol was not just an Asherah, but it was a monstrous Asherah. It was a giant Asherah, specifically in the Hebrew. It was a super giant tree, and he burnt it. That's what Asa did. So these notes. So the gods of the pagans, of the Sodomites, of the giants, the Kenites, the son of Cain, sons of Cain, of the lineage of Cain, were specifically the children of Cain, the giants, offspring of the Nephilim, of the bloodline, the fallen ones, were specifically tree worshippers worshipping these giant trees, and they were considered idols. It says it right here, that they were considered idols by Yahweh. He hated it. So if he burnt the idol, which means tree, Asherah, that's what it means in Hebrew, idols. So let's go to Exodus 20 to wrap this up. Exodus chapter 20. Wow, here we are at the Ten Commandments. And Yahweh spake all these words saying, one, the first commandment, I am Yahweh, the Elohim, which have brought thee out of the land of Egypt, out of the house of bondage. I've set you free. Thou shalt have no other gods before me. The first commandment is not to worship these giant trees. That's how big this is. It's how huge. People say, well, where's, you know, what is it in the Bible, you know, what is this no force thing? Well, the first commandment, the Ten Commandments, the first one is about not worshiping idols. The specific meaning of idols is Asherah. What are the Asherahs? The giant trees. The second commandment, also, I'm no other gods before me. That was part of the first commandment. Let's see here in my notes. Okay, let's get it. The second commandment, thou shalt not make unto thee any graven image or any likeness of anything that is in heaven above, or that is in the earth beneath, or that is in the water under the earth. Graven in Hebrew is Tim Unah, comes from the Hebrew word 4327 in the Strong's. It's something fashioned out as a shape. It is a phantom or an embodiment or a manifestation. So it's not just these things, but it's not, the second commandment is not just about worshiping these things, but is equally forbidden to make them or to worship them. So anything to do with this tree worship. And the second commandment continues, thou shalt not bow down before thyself to them, nor serve them. For I, Yahweh, thy Elohim, am a jealous Elohim, visiting the iniquity of the fathers upon the children unto the third and fourth generation of them that hate me. Verse 6. And showing mercy unto thousands of them that love me and keep my commandments. Visiting, charging, the burden of Yahweh's revelation of himself. The punishment being not lengthened in vengeance, but distributed mercy over three and four generations, so that the whole weight did not fall on the first and second generation.